Hey, what's up, everybody? Prestige here, and I am joined today with MrDalekJD.
Hello, everyone. How are you doing?
And if you aren't familiar with this channel, you can find a link down below in the description. Basically, he covers zombies. He is the zombie expert, and I invited him to this commentary because we're going to talk a little bit more in depth about the zombies wave that is included in exo-survival. And I just watched one of his videos, which I will link that video down below in the description, and he basically covered everything that I was thinking about. Plus more, and I kind of want to pick his brain a little bit, and I hopefully he can pick my brain a little bit on some of the stuff. So hopefully you guys enjoy. If you do, remember to drop a like down below. But basically, what MrDalekJD was saying is that he thinks that there is going to be another mode than just this one singular wave. And do you want to let my crowd know why you think that?
Yeah, well, if you just think about it realistically, Sledgehammer Games have gone through such a massive effort to create a zombie-esque looking skin on several soldiers, and you see one with an exoskeleton, one without. Surely, if they've gone through such an effort to create a skin and to create new AI to behave like zombies, surely they're going to use it in more than just one bonus wave. It seems silly for them to just throw that all away after one single bonus wave, right?
It wouldn't even seem right. I mean, you have the assets for everything there. You know, believe it or not, some zombies do look similar, some copy and paste zombies after wave, but it would just seem so silly for them not to include an external type of thing. You know what I mean? I don't know. I think that there is going to be something else, but that's the question. What else is there going to be? Is it going to be some sort of zombie mode similar to what Treyarch has done? Is it going to be something completely separate, like exo-survival? Or exo-survivor or something where you're like a singular survivor and you have to go in? Or is it going to be co-op mode? Hopefully it's co-op mode. But yeah, I mean, it's just something that would seem so silly for them not to use since they have all the assets right at their fingertips. And it would seem like it maybe would even drop as a DLC in the future of some sort.
Well, in my video, I kind of said that this could almost be like a sort of spanner in the works to see how people react to this bonus wave, and if it's popular, then DLC in the future could have like maybe an option in Exo Survival with the new maps to change the enemies from just typical soldiers that shoot at you to zombies. I think that could be kind of cool.
I think so too, and that's another thing that it makes me wonder, like, this one round, how long is this round going to be? 2 minutes? 3 minutes? How many zombies are actually going to come at us? That's another thing.
Really good question. Something else to note as well, the achievement is only specific to the map Riot, which makes it seem even more weird to make it for one specific bonus round on only one exo-survival map. It's it's weird.
And I almost wonder if it's going to be like in the same setup like we've seen in Modern Warfare 3, where you have to unlock the first four levels, then you can get the next four, then you can get the next four. You know what I mean? Like, you had to do each of those four levels and get those completed or go to a certain wave before you can unlock the next four. Like, they weren't all available right at the start. You had to play like your first block. It was like easy mode. Then second was like medium. The next one was hard. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I wonder if they're going to put something special in there where it's like a special section where it's like zombie survival and there's four different maps you can play, or if it's going to be like exo zombie survival or something of the sort. And that brings another question in with the exo zombies. Obviously, we see those zombies with exosuits in the screenshot. What are they going to be able to do? I brought this up in a video before. Are they going to be able to super run, cloak themselves, have shields on them? I mean, that'd be like fighting a boss round or something. There's so much they can do with that. You know, and they have the creative genius there at the studio in order to complete something like that. So I'm not really sure exactly what they're going to be able to do with this secret mode, if it's even going to be a separate mode. But like you were saying, it would be so silly for them not to put it into another mode.
It'd be such a shame if that was literally all we ever saw from it, because, like, as you said before, Sledgehammer Games are like really on point with what the community want, and there's no doubt they must have had tens of thousands of tweets from people asking zombies, literally the word zombies. And like, they can't really rain on Treyarch's parade, because that is something set in stone. That is theirs, no doubt about it. But for
that's
me,
that's one reason why people buy Treyarch games.
Exactly. But me as a zombie fan, I'm happy for them to include zombies in this sort of way, because it's not you know, stepping on Treyarch's ground, it's doing something a little bit different. But I'm hoping that in the future we'll see more from this, like sparking its own game mode. Even if it's just like options to switch from soldiers to zombies, that could totally have a different way on the way Exo Survival even plays. That'll be really, really crazy.
I mean, you wouldn't have enemies firing back at you. Yeah. It would just be a mess of zombies running at you. And that's another thing, like, even if they were to make their own sort of, like, Treyarch-style zombie experience where it is round-based, it wouldn't be anywhere near similar to Treyarch's because of the exosuits. Just talking about ghosts for a moment, we've seen what they did with the movement style of the aliens in Extinction. Yep. They bounce up the walls all over the place, go invisible with the phantoms.
It's crazy.
Everything. I mean, you can imagine what a soldier could do in an exosuit. So it wouldn't be similar in any sort of way, but it would be a nice nostalgic thing to have since it's been so long since we've had a Treyarch game.
Yep, I totally agree. Like, I can imagine right now, zombies with exo-survival suits, they'll be able to double jump their way onto elevated platforms. They'd still have that weird slow running, maybe even walking animation. But I can imagine, like, for the start of rounds, you could literally have zombies jetpacking into the map. Rather than spawning from like ridiculous. A barricade, you could literally have them like in different locations just slowly make their way into the map from the air.
Zombies that actually have a brain and yes. know how to like attack you.
Yeah,
that would be crazy.
Don't get me wrong, I love Treyarch's games, I love Treyarch Zombies so much. It's always got a spot in my heart, but you have to agree here that the AI on the zombies is not revolutionary. It's not something which is a massive challenge. You know exactly how they're behaving, you know what they're going to do in every sort of situation. If you have something like this, it's going to completely change up the gameplay because you can't predict what the zombies are going to do.
Exactly, you can't predict whether that zombie is going to double jump to take you off guard, or is it going to strafe around a corner with a boost strafe, or what's it going to do?
Oh my god.
Just could you imagine zombies just like
putting weird thoughts in my head.
Just imagine a zombie boost strafing around the corner and his arm like flies off because of the force.
Oh,
because
that'd
it's
be
just
so
held
cool.
on by tendons. It's just like
that would be amazing.
That would be awesome. I mean, honestly, like I was saying, if they do their own separate mode, I think it'd bring a nice breath of fresh air to, you know, like a hidden co-op mode like we've seen with Extinction. And it wouldn't be similar to Extinction. It wouldn't be similar to Treyarch's Zombies. It'd be completely Sledgehammer's own. Yeah. And I think that's what's cool. And another thing to touch base on, we have no clue what Raven Software is doing. We have no clue.
They are working on the game in some way.
They must be working on some sort of DLC. That's what they did with Modern Warfare 3, but Raven Software also helped with Extinction Mode on Call of Duty Ghosts, so that is something to think about and mull over as well while we wait for the approaching days. We are about 20 days away.
Oh my god.
From Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, so it's definitely going to be really, really cool. I have no idea what exactly these zombies are going to have in turn. I really, really hope they don't do it for just one wave, because that would be such a bummer. Like you were saying, they got the assets there. They can definitely do something with it. And that makes me wonder, because dogs were shown in the trailer, not zombie dogs, of course, but dogs cool. were shown in the regular survival mode. So I wonder if there's going to be some sort of like zombie dog variant.
Oh my God.
Like an actual zombie dog, not like a hellhound, like something you'd see in Resident Evil or something.
Wow. So just before Prestige ends his video, I just want to plant a little idea into your brain. Now, throughout the multiplayer reveal of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, they've shown four different multiplayer maps. Now, I've noticed two maps that have very strange things inside the maps. These maps are Biolab and Riot. Now, we know that the achievement for the zombies is linked only to Riot, but in Biolab, around the map, you'll find chambers or like big massive jars with weird bodies inside attached to tubes, which doesn't look quite right. Something's happened here. Now, maybe I'm looking too close into the story because they're simply just multiplayer maps, but I do think there's something there. And on the map Riot, in the main building where you see all the different prison cells, some cells have a skeleton. And on next to that skeleton, some cells have a brain next to it, and there'll be like cells next to it, and some of those will simply have a skeleton with no brain, which made
that
me think that there could be some prisoners held in there against their will, and there's some higher some higher force that is cloning people in these prison cells, hence why we have zombies on riot.
That's pretty interesting, actually, now that you bring that up. Just think about it. What if the soldiers or the doors that just have the skeleton showing and no brain, what if those are just normal zombies, and then the other ones with the brains are the ones with the exosuits, because they know how to use them?
Potentially.
That is pretty cool. That, now that you bring that up, I definitely noticed that as well on Riot, so... Mm-hmm. That would BioLab, yeah, what's going on there?
I just thought that there has to be a reason why they're putting this in there. They can't just let you be adding it just for scenery or to make it look good. There has to be a reason behind it.
I mean, maybe in the story mode with BioLab, I can see like them trying to genetically modify soldiers. Like that seems like a reasonable thing. But with the jail cells and the skeletons and the brains, that doesn't really click anywhere for me. Mm-hmm. So I think that could definitely be some sort of, like, what if the round starts and all the doors open and then all of them start coming out and just running like,
that would be so crazy. And also, in the map, you have those walls that have crumbled because something's crashed into it to get out of the prison. So that's something else to think about. Thought I'd just add that in there just to get your minds working.
Definitely. What if I can only imagine, like, out in the prison yard, because I can just think of it, that place is so wide open, that's a training location.
Yep.
Like, if they happen to run the same direction like Treyarch zombies, but they'd be getting like lazed by the prisoner system, and they'd be like,
that would be so fun to watch.
Oh my goodness, that's awesome. That is a great theory. That'd be pretty terrifying, but anyway, I think that you guys have enough information by now to know what we are getting at here.
Yep.
We want something else. So if you guys want something else as well, let us know down below in the comment section what you think about it. And do not forget to check out Mr. DalekJD's channel, link down below in the description. Thank you so much for joining me, dude, today.
It's all right. It's a pleasure, my friend. Anytime. It's been fun.
All right. And next time we talk about zombies, I'll have to bring in the expert because he knows exactly what's going on here.
Well, all righty,
guys. Until next time, everybody, I'm out. Peace.
Peace.